In the Southwest, flash floods are quite common. This makes it extremely difficult for our scientists to measure each peak while it occurs at each one of our stream gauges. These flood peaks are very important to document and can help refine the high flow rating calibration at each one of our stream gauges. To estimate peak flows at gauges where direct measurements were impossible to obtain, we use indirect methods to measure these flows. These methods require us to survey the channel geometry and high water marks left by the flood. We are here today in Catalina State Park, which is in Oro Valley, Arizona, just north of Tucson. We brought our new surveying equipment here to do a kind of a test scan. This new equipment is the first equipment we've had that can integrate GPS, LiDAR, and traditional line of sight prism surveys. Previously, we've just had total stations, or just had LiDAR, or just had GPS. They didn't necessarily communicate in the field. These can all get on the same page all at once, which increases our efficiency immensely in the field. When we have a scanner like this, we can get a complete model, a complete 3D model of the entire stream channel throughout the reach that we think is best. And once we get back to the office, we can analyze this model and choose our cross sections so that they are in the best possible locations to conduct a 1D flow model. This is a typical stream that we would get called out to after a large flood, because it could potentially impact the people and the campers inside the park. Okay, so we have that point, and the next thing we need to do is measure this same exact point and not move. We need to measure it with the total station. Now what we're doing is we've just set up our total station, but we're not over a known point. So using the GPS data, the total station is going to calculate where it is on the surface of the planet, basically, and how far it is above land surface here, so that we know exactly where the GPS, or where the total station, is located. And then we can start collecting data from the total station and all three sensors: the RTK base, the RTK rover, which is here, and this total station will all be communicating together and on the same survey plane. The base station continually collects data every 5 minutes. It communicates with all the available satellites going over. Right now it's connected to 17 satellites and is trying to find its exact location. And over the 3 hour period while we survey that, the more points that that's able to store every 5 minutes, the higher accuracy it has on its exact location, which every other point that we collect today will be anchored to that point. So the longer that sits there and collects data, the better. With all of this equipment, we're more efficient, and we're collecting much more data, and we can do it with much less manpower. It's really going to change the game on how we respond to major flooding.